what you see. You see brothers that got themselves together. Ecclesiastes 7:7. Because you say you tired of the BS. Hey, that's why every man is out here on the corner. That's why you see this purple spread across the U.S., spread across the globe. Because we tired of the BS. Right. So what? Yeah. We out here to get our brothers off the streets, off of drugs, off of alcoholism, out of gangs. Why? Because, hey, I once was foolish,
that's
too.
A strong attempt.
Hey, I once was foolish, too. Quote that Titus 3:3. Hey, I once was foolish, too. I gang bang, all of that. You know what I'm saying? Those different things, them symbols on your hat mean something.
I'm
just saying, like, when we all come from, we all come from a different walk of life.
Right.
What you gotta do, bro, you gotta just really, really humble because, hey, somebody been through what you've been through.
Right.
Hey, and when you come in the body, they're gonna be able to get you through
right.
whatever you're going through. Read what you got.
Right. The book of Titus 3:3. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish.
Every man right here was sometimes foolish. We all sold drugs, gang bang. Some of us pimp.
Right.
Some of us did a little bit of everything, bro. Read.
For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish.
Come on.
Disobedient, deceived, serving diverse lusts.
We all was disobedient and deceived. You know what I'm saying? Hey, what's your name, King?
Jesse.
I'm Ciroc. Hey, look, Ciroc. Check us out. Oh, pound me, bro.
Oh, my bad.
Okay, hey, check this out. Check this out. Read this from the top.
The book of Titus 3:3.
Come on.
For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish.
Hey, we all was going through something. We all was sometimes foolish. Read.
Disobedient.
Disobedient. We didn't disobey somebody. Read.
Deceived.
Deceived the Christian church. You know what I'm saying? These pastors. We was all once deceived. Let me let that go. We all was once deceived. Read.
Serving diverse lusts.
Hey, we serve diverse lusts. You know what I'm saying? My lust was drugs, women, and alcohol. You know what I'm saying? Read.
And pleasures.
Read.
Living in malice and envy.
Hey, I had hatred because a brother had a different color bandana hanging from an opposite side.
Right.
I had hatred for my brother. Why? Because he stayed on another block, two blocks away from me. I had hatred for that brother. Why? Hey, because that's where his family grew up. So, hey, we don't get along with that side. Hatred. Read.
Teach up. Hateful. And hating one another.
Hey, and you know why I had that hatred like that? Because I hated myself. You know what I'm saying? Because I didn't see Christ in that brother. That's why when you walked over here, I said, hey, King. You see what I'm saying? Because it's a difference. It's a different mentality I put. You walk away from here when I'm not calling you, hey, my nigga. I'm calling you King, so now you can think highly of yourself.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You follow me? Ecclesiastes 7:7.
The book of Ecclesiastes 7:7.
Hey, and the Lord allowed y'all brothers to come over here. You know what I'm saying? What's your nationality?
where is?
You don't know your race?
Yeah, no, black and white. I was just having this with father? One of your brothers.
What's your father?
Yeah, white.
Your father's white?
Yes, sir.
All right, Ecclesiastes 7:7.
I was just having this conversation.
Ecclesiastes 7:7. Surely oppression.
Huh?
What is your race?
What's my race? I'm an Israelite from the tribe of Judah.
That's right!
You know what I'm saying? I was a so-called black man, you know what I'm saying, about 7 years ago. Now I'm an Israelite from the tribe of Judah. Right. I'm a prince that has power with God.
Right.
Now, I'm God's praise.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I got royal lineage running through my veins.
Right.
And I see that same thing in you.
Teach Ecclesiastes 7:7.
Come on.
Surely oppression making a wise man mad.
Surely oppression make a wise man mad. Hey, they just think we yelling on a loudspeaker. That makes me angry right there. Seeing my brothers in the lower state
right.
makes me angry. Oppression.
You was
because
there.
My
it
people
make
are
you.
Oppressed. My people are oppressed, so I'm angry at that. Surely oppression make a wise man mad. What you see around you is wise men. And we do not like, hey, if we like the conditions that we was in, we wouldn't even be out here.
Right,
we'd be joining y'all.
Right.
But we don't like the conditions that our people are in.
Right.
So, hey, we gonna hit the highways and hedges and wake our people up. And we got that speaker out, so it's not just for you. It's for the next brother up the block.
There.
Exactly. Read.
And a gift destroyeth the heart.
Hey, and these gifts that they keep on giving us, welfare. Christmas presents, all these destroying our mind. They destroying our mind out here. You know what I'm saying? All the free food and different things like that destroying our mind.
Right.
Hey, exactly.
They don't need to give it to us.
If
they got hunting season and shit, it's a lot of food out here to eat. Fish, You know how to fish.
Hey, we gotta know who we giving it to. Hey, you see any of these brothers right here? Hey, I'm gonna make sure they.
Animal, how you gonna give it? Even the zebra gonna go to the water hole and drink his water.
Hey, you gotta know who you giving it to though, bruh. You gotta know who you dealing with. I know who I'm dealing with right here. I'm just not gonna give anybody nothing. Dude. You know what I'm saying? Because why? I don't know if that brother gonna go get high with it. Right. I don't know if he gonna go get drunk with it. Hey, I don't know that. That's but I know these men right here ain't gonna do that. Right. So hey, if they need some bread for their light bill, you know what I'm saying? They need a little chili for what? For their water bill. I'ma give them that. Because right. I know for a fact they not gonna go smoke it. They not gonna go get drunk. Right. Huh?
If I'm in the middle of the wilderness and my body is real with bullets, then you come across me. Now I'm about to die, we all die.
Right.
I'm not dead because I'm talking to you, but I need you to give me a shot of whiskey, nigga, and put this bullet in my head to get this pain.
I'm not about to do that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not about to do that. I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. You know what I'm saying? Because the Bible say, thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not kill. So why would I kill you? You know what I'm saying? Why, and why would you have all those bullets in you? Now I gotta ask that question. Why you got there? Why? How did
why
this happen?
You in the Western? I don't know. Maybe I was trying to save somebody's life. That's good. Hey, we don't know. We don't know.
But
right now,
but you said it.
You came across me.
Yeah.
When you came across me.
Right.
You're not gonna help me. You're not gonna help me.
I'm helping you right now. Watch this. Psalms 107 and 20. I'm helping you right now.
Bring it out.
I'm helping you right now. Believe it or not, you just kicking against the pricks. You know what I'm saying? Hey, but check it out. I'm going to show you how I'm going to help you. Read.
The book of Psalms, chapter 107, verse 20.
Come on,
read it out. He sent his word and healed them.
Hey, he said he sent his word and healed them. What word did he send to them? Hold that Isaiah 8 and 20. What word did he send to them? He said he sent his word. You say you want the help? I'm going to give you the help. Hey, I'm going to give you the help that's going to help you help somebody else. That's if you really want the help, though. Psalms 107 and 20. Read.
Isaiah, my bad.
Isaiah, chapter 8, verse 20. To the law and to the testimony. If they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no sign, no light in them.
Read it again.
To the law and to the testimony. If they speak not according to this word.
He said, to the law and to the testimony. Hey, my brother, I'm going to give you the law. Hey, you shouldn't buy, sell, and trade on the Lord's Sabbath day. Keep the Lord's Sabbath holy. Hey, and then you ain't got to worry about having a bullet in you. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm going to show you how to, you got kids? You got kids? I'm going to show you how to be a father to your father, to your kids. Hey, if you ain't got no kids, I'm going to show you how to be a father to the fatherless.
Bring it
up. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to show you how to stand up manfully according to the Bible.
That's
I'm going to teach you the laws of God. Read.
It is because there is no light in them.
Hey, that's what you see right here. You see a light shining bright
on all four corners.
Right. On all four corners. A light shining bright. Back to Psalms 107 and 20. This is how I'm going to heal you, big bro. Read.
The book of Psalms, chapter 107, verse 20. He sent his word and healed them.
He sent his word and healed them. The word is the commandments of God that we just read in Isaiah. That's how I'm going to heal you. Read.
He sent his word and healed them.
Read.
And delivered them from their destruction.
Hey, we trying to deliver you from your destruction. Whatever you battling, bruh, if you come deal with the prophets, we going to help you overcome that. Two is better than one.
Right.
Huh?
That you are preaching. I want to drink my beer.
You want to drink your beer?
And I'm going to go.
Okay.
Over here, but I'm going to come back.
You with that. I'm sick.
And I want to be here because you said I was sick. I didn't say I was sick. You said I was sick.
Hey, you just
I'm gonna drink my beer.
When you said you're gonna go drink your beer.
Right.
It's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
I don't want to drink.
You don't want to drink?
No. Hey, I'm gonna go drink
my
beer.
What?
I just like if you game bang, hey, that's your choice.
I'm an alcoholic too. So come on. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna deal with that.
Right.
You right up my alley.
Right.
You right up my alley. I used to drink at 2 p.m. in the afternoon too.
If it's time for my birthday,
Mad Dog.
Go. I have to do certain things to be around certain people.
No, you don't.
I don't, but I do.
You choose.
People say that. Did I choose to be born here in Oklahoma talking to y'all right now, or did it happen?
The Lord chose you. The Lord ordained you to do that. Hey, Isaiah 5, come on.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 5, verse 11.
Hey, this is what the Bible say. This is what the Bible say, big bro. Read.
Woe unto them that rise up early in the morning, that they may follow strong drink.
Hey, he said, big bro, he said, woe to them that rise up early in the morning that they may follow strong drink. I'm almost certain that's not your first beer of the day.
Correct.
Because your eyes are closed. You know what I'm saying? So I can tell. You know what I'm saying? So he say, woe. What does that word woe mean? What does that word woe mean? We could deal with that as well. I used to do that as well. You know what I'm saying? But the Bible changed. What does woe mean? Go give me that hope, that song, Hosea 7 and 14.
Woe mean a lot of shit.
No, woe mean destruction. Yeah. I'm going to show you what the Bible said about it. Hey, and you gonna destroy yourself out here drinking. No, you wasn't.
Oh, I believe different. I read my Bible too.
The book of Hosea, chapter 7, verse 14.
Bring it out.
And they have not cried unto me with their heart.
13.
Verse 13.
Come on.
Woe unto them, for they have fled from me.
He say, woe unto them, because they have fled from me. You trying to run from the Most High right now. Hey, his God.
Men of Israel.
No. Finish your point.
Okay. He say, woe unto me, because they have fled from me. Bro, you trying to run away from the scripture.
No, God with the shit.
That's what we're showing you. He's telling you it's going to be destruction if you continue down your path.
Woe unto
them, for they have fled from me. Destruction unto them, because they have transgressed against me.
Destruction unto you, because you have transgressed against God's laws. You out here buying, selling, and trading, and then you want to go get drunk when the prophet is trying to
do. I don't know this is Sabbath.
I'm trying to show you that, but you being rebellious. Get out of the street before you get hit, for the destruction come early. I'm trying to say this.
Nation is men leading by example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models.